What is up, guys? It's Cal, and in this video, we're going to be doing a tier list of hunter pets. Kind of unusual video of me to make, but there's nothing to do in WoW right now, and I'm waiting on patch 9.1 to come out for all the new content that that has in store. So anyways, this is a tier list of hunter pets, as I just said. There are 59 pet families in the game as of recording this, which is in beginning of Shadowlands. And I feel like I have to say this every time I make a video about hunter pets, but all hunter pets do the same amount of damage. No pets do more damage than others, except there's a few, and by few I mean I think literally three hunter pets, pet families in the game that have a special ability that has something to do with damage. And I'll of course be talking about those when I go over those when I, look at those hunter pets. But this is kind of, in my opinion, I've been playing a hunter for 15 years in WoW. I started playing WoW in 2006, and I've been a hunter main ever since vanilla. So I'd like to think I have a good knowledge on hunters, especially hunter pets, because hunter pets have been revamped so many times since the beginning of WoW. And there are some iterations of hunter pets that are, better than how hunter pets are currently. My kind of opinion on how hunter pets are currently is that there's a lot less customization as there was before. And I think Blizzard stated something around when hunter pets got massively revamped semi-recently, that they didn't want hunter pets to be the complete identity of the hunter, essentially. Because a bunch of hunter pets have pretty much the exact same reskinned abilities. They're just named something different. There's like probably about 10 of these pets that have the same special ability that just like reduces the target's movement speed, or something simple like that. In fact, hunter pets, and I'm rambling on here, we'll get into the tier list in a minute, but hunter pets were in their prime. I think, I forget when, I think it may have been Warlords, which would have been the only good thing Warlords would have had with it. It may have been Mists, I can't remember, Warlords or Mists, but hunter pets had, well, first off, you could change the spec of your pet, whether ferocity, cunning, or tenacity, and pretty much every hunter pet family had a different special ability. Like Shale spiders, which are now called Shale beasts, their special ability would like stun the target for like 4 seconds, so you'd have like a second intimidation. Spiders would like root the targets for 6 seconds or something. Monkeys could literally, where are monkeys on this list? Monkeys could literally throw their poop at enemies and it would disorient them for 6 seconds. Those are just a few I remember, but I think it was actually Mists, because Warlords of Draenor had nothing good going on with it. I think it was Mists when hunter pets were in their prime. But anyways, hunters are they're pretty easy to understand now. It's pretty much, you got three pet specs: tenacity, cunning, and ferocity. Do their own abilities. Hunter pet families have their own, abilities with them. Anyways, let's get into the tier list, because I pretty much know all of the hunter pet family abilities because I have no life. So we'll get into starting here. I will obviously be going over like exotic pets versus non-exotics. Exotic pets might be like towards the top of the list, but not all of them, because there are some exotic pets that have god-awful abilities that are just bad. And I'll be talking about those. Anyways, Karapids. Starting off with Karapids. Karapids are a good tank pet. They're a good tank pet, especially since their tenacity. Tenacity pets, of course, have Survival of the Fittest, which is a defensive cooldown, which puts a defensive cooldown or puts a defensive on you and your pet. I'm gonna have to put Karapids, I think if there was a B plus category, I would put them there, but I'm gonna put them at a B. Karapids are a B. They're not any pet I would use in raids or PvP. I would use it, it's a good soloing type of pet. So there's of course that. Now, carrion birds. Carrion birds, non-exotic. Their ferocity, they're pretty good. Don't have anything special going on with them. Their special ability is a mortal wounds, which is like you have to have a mortal wounds if you're doing PvP. Well, not all PvP. Like, for example, Battlegrounds, I'd probably go with like a Spirit Beast or something. But if you're doing arenas, you definitely want a pet that has a Mortal Wounds. But there's a lot better Mortal Wounds pets to pick than Carrion Birds. Mainly because Carrion Birds are Ferocity. And if we're going to use a pet for PvP, use a Cunning Pet. I'm going to put Carrion Birds at C. Cats. So cats are pretty good pets. Kind of. Sort of. Not really. The thing about cats is that they have a special ability. There are three pet families in the game. If you didn't know this, there are three pet families in the game that actually have an extra ability. Blizzard decided to give these pets extra abilities for literally no reason at all. They just did. Those are cats, Feathermanes right there, and Spirit Beasts, which are down here. I'll be going over their, you know, special ability when I get there, but because of that, I can't put cats at a C, I think. Actually, you know what? I'm going to put cats at a C. I'm going to put cats at a C because, actually, you know what? I'm going to be nice. I'm going to put them at a B. Because they are Ferocity, you'd never use a cat in PvP. If you were to use a cat, you'd use it in raids. And Ferocity pets are pretty good for raids, especially if you don't, you know, or instance content, if you're with a group. Like, if you don't have a hero or Bloodlust, you would obviously, you know, hunters obviously want to have Ferocity pet in that case, so then they can provide their group with that haste buff. But cat's special abilities are, so they're normal special abilities, cat-like reflexes, which increases their dodge by 30%. It's nothing special. And then their other special ability is Prowl. And actually, you know what? I'm putting cats at a C. I'm sorry, I flip-flopped on cats. Prowl is annoying to use. It's god-awful. Prowl makes your pet slow. Now, the first attack that your pet does outside of Prowl does do more damage. That's what it does. But Prowl is just annoying to use because your pet's movement speed is reduced by like 50% or something like that. And so I just, look, fight me in the comments below. I just have to put cats at a C, I'm sorry. Maybe a C plus, but I'm gonna put them at a C. Chimeras. So chimeras are good pets. They are definitely good pets. So they are exotic, of course. Their special ability is their normal special ability is Frost Breath, which reduces the target's movement speed by 50%, which is, you know, it's pretty good. Why not? Reduces the target speed of the enemy. And then their exotic ability is called Frost Storm Breath. Now, Frost Storm Breath is a frontal AoE ability that does damage. So these are one of the very few pets that have a special ability that deals damage. The thing about the damage of it is it's so minuscule. Like, I actually haven't tested it since Shadowlands has been out. I tested it prior to Shadowlands. Even with the level squish and stat squish and all that, I don't think, like, relatively speaking, it's much different. But over a 5-minute fight, it did 1.2% of my damage. But their ferocity. So you know what? I had to put Chimeras in A. Chimeras are pretty good pets. Cleftuffs as well are pretty good pets. Cleftuffs are very good tanking pets, except for the fact that they don't have Survival of the Fittest, which is fine. I was about to just instantly put Cleftuffs at A. That almost makes me want to put it at B. But Ferocity's not bad. I have to put Cleftuffs at an A. They're better tanking pets than Carapids, I think. Their special ability is Thick Hide, which, it's like when they fall below 40% health, I think it is, then they take 60% less damage. And that's on like a 2-minute cooldown. But it's still a very good ability if you're wanting to like tank something. I know when I do some instance content, I have to do solo for different reasons. And I typically use a Cleftuff. Their exotic ability is Blood of the Rhino, which it increases their armor and increases the healing that they take by 10%. So that's already really good. Their armor's increased and then Mend Pet does more to them. So Cleftuffs I have to put at an A. Corehounds. So Corehounds are another one of the very few pet families in the game which have special abilities that have to do with DPS, similar to Chimeras. Corehounds also look cool, I think. They look pretty cool. Their special ability is, they have two because they're exotic, is Obsidian Skin, I think. That's their like normal special ability. Which, if I remember, all it just reduces the damage that they take, which is, you know, pretty okay. And then Molten Hide, it's like, I don't know the percentage exactly, but like when they get hit, they reflect some of the damage back at the attacker. I have to put Corehounds at B, I think. Yeah, let's not dwell on it too much. I think they have to be at a B. Corsairs are, Corsairs are not that good. Some of them look cool, like Dream Runners look cool. Because of that, I have to put them at a C. I was about to put them at an F, but because there are some really cool looking Corsairs, like cool Dream Runners, there's horses in the beginning of Shadowfang Keep that have like fiery hooves that look really cool. So they have to go to C for that. Their special ability increases their dodge, similar to cats. Crabs. So crabs. Crabs are actually, well, they're not that great. What I was going to say is that crabs, I remember back when pets were a lot better in like the Mists of Pandaria area, crabs could disarm the enemies. Crabs could disarm your enemies, which was OP. It was really good. If you're facing like a warrior or something like that, or a rogue. Crabs are not very good pets. Although there are some cool looking crabs in Najitar. There are these crabs that have like really long legs in Najitar that are pretty cool, but you know what? You know what? Let's do this. D. I have to, just for crabs at least, crabs have to be D. Cranes. Cranes, pet introduced in Mists of Pandaria. Their special ability used to be really good. We're not talking about used to, though, anymore. We're talking about now. Crane's special abilities used to be a battle res. Too bad hunters don't have battle reses anymore. Because now their special ability, it's called Chi-Gi's Tranquility. Which is a, it's like a self-pet dispel sort of thing. Where it can dispel like diseases or magic effects from the target. There aren't a lot of cool cranes, to be honest. So I have to put them at a D. Yeah. Not a whole lot of cool cranes. All cranes pretty much look the same. Who knows, maybe one day we'll be able to tame Chi-Gi. Probably never, because that would be really weird. But anyways, let's move on to Crocolisks. So Crocolisks are ferocity. They are, their special ability is like a movement impairing type of thing. And similar to, cranes and crabs, there's not a lot of cool looking crocolisks, so gotta stick my D. Don't worry, I will be putting a pet at an F, and I already have in mind what the pet is that's going to go into that category. So Akiri are exotic pets. Now Akiris have a movement impairing effect. That's one of their abilities. And then the other ability is kind of strange. It like increases their movement speed by 30% or something like that. I'm trying to think, cool looking. I mean, there's a lot of cool Silphids, Akiris. They might have to go, you know what? I'm gonna put them at a C, just because. Devil Sores, okay. So Devil Sores are kinda good, but what they lack in goodness, they make up for in looks. So Devil Sores are ferocity. In fact, I used to always use a Devil Sore back when I played Beast Mastery, because they're exotic. A big reason for that is because there are a lot of cool looking Devil Sores. Like there's Thok the Bloodthirsty from Siege of Orgrimmar. There is, what's that? Undasta on the Isle of Giants. I wonder if one expansion they let us tame Razan from A Tall Desire. Probably never, because it would be really weird to allow us to tame a wild god. But just throwing that out there, Blizzard. Their abilities are Monstrous Bite. which is a mortal wounds. So they were a pet that I used to use a lot for. They were my go-to PvP pet, Devil Swords, because of that. But there's better PvP pets than Devil Swords. The other thing, their other ability is useless. It's called Feast, which is a... it's like a cannibalize. I've never actively used it in combat. I've only used it like 3 times out of combat just to see what it looks like. But it's a pretty useless ability. Man, I think I might have to put Devil Swords at a C. But there are some really cool models of them. But you know what? I'm going to put them at a C. Even though there are some cool models, it makes me want to bump them up to a B. But usefulness, they're kind of a meh. Direhorns. There are a lot of cool looking Direhorns. Now, Direhorn's special abilities, it's called Gore, I think. It's like Immortal Wounds as well. Similar to Devil Source, except Direhorns are non-exotic, although you do need a Tome of Dinomancy to be able to tame Direhorns, which you get from killing Zandalari trolls on the Isle of Giants. I think I might have to put them... I gotta go with a D. They're not very useful. Actually, they are cunning. No, they're a cunning pet with immortal wounds. So I have to put them at a B, I guess. Yeah, because they're a cunning pet with immortal wounds. So they deserve that B slot. Dragonhawks. So Dragonhawks' special ability is pretty useless. It's like similar to cats, increases their dodge. I believe that's what it is. I've never really used a Dragonhawk pet. Because there's not really a whole lot of cool looking Dragonhawks. There's a lot of Dragonhawks around like Silverman City and all that. Those are like really the only Dragonhawk models that come to mind. Yeah, they're D tier. Feathermanes are really good. I really like Feathermanes. Because not only are they... I like Feathermanes for a lot of reasons. So get your notepads out. This is why I like Feathermanes. They look cool. There's actually a lot of interesting Feathermane models that were added in Shadowlands. That's the current expansion. Like Larions that you see all over Bastion, and those owl steeds, you know, those things that are all over Bastion, those are all Feathermanes. There's a lot of cool looking Feathermanes in like Azuna, Lalathan, I think that's how you pronounce his name, which is a rare to get Feathermane in Gul'dan's raid. What is it called? The Night Raid. Oh god. I have to look this up because this is gonna bug me. Nighthold. It's called Nighthold. Wow. Yikes. Lalathan is like a rare Featherman that you can see there. It has a cool model. I made a video on how to get it. So, Feathermanes look cool. Not only that, Feathermanes are one of the three pets in the game that I was talking about before that have a special ability. They have an extra ability. Featherman's extra ability is a slow fall. A hunter having a slow fall. I think it's just Feathermanes and Wolfhawks. Where are Wolfhawks? Wolfhawks are part of the Rylic family, I'm pretty sure. I could be completely wrong about that. But yeah, they have slow fall. So their other ability, I think it like increases their dodge. Something like that. I only care about Feathermanes because of slow fall. Had to put Feathermanes at... ooh. Let's put him at an A. Or B. I have to put him at a B. Because their other ability is useless. Slowfall is good. They have cool models. I have to put him at a B for that. Foxes. So, Foxes' special ability is... their tenacity, their special ability is... increases their dodge. There are some pretty cool Foxes... I'm pretty sure there's a lot of foxes in Ardenweald that were added. There's also Lightning Paw, that lightning fox. I was trying to think of what its name was. Cool looking foxes, tenacity, their tenacity. So they give you Survival of the Fittest, increase your stamina. They're pretty C tier, not gonna lie. Foxes are a C tier. Gorillas Ferocity, of course. Their special ability, I believe it's similar. I don't think I've really ever used a gorilla, to be honest. Their special ability, I'm pretty sure, is similar to the Cleftuff one, where it's like when they drop below 40% health, increases their dodge and all that. There's not a lot of cool looking gorilla models. Actually, there are some robotic gorillas that look cool. But sorry, gorillas... gorillas have to go D tier. They really do. Gruffalhorns, which are rams. I don't know why they decided to call them Gruffalhorns. Maybe because their special ability is called Gruff. I think, yeah, that's what it's called. It's called Gruff, which is the exact same thing as gorillas. And because of that, yeah, Gruffalhorns, they gotta go there. Hounds. Now, Hounds' special ability is reduces movement speed type of deal. They are tenacity. Thing about Hounds is that there are a lot of cool Hound-looking models. There are. Like, Garm in Trial of Valor, three-headed, you know, Hound. That is a Hound. And, yeah, except you actually can't tame Garm in the Trial of Valor. There's an outdoor version of Garm in Helheim for you to tame. So, there's that. Also, there's a lot of, like, skeletal-looking hounds. Also, Precious and Stinky and ICC, those are undead hounds. Also, the Worgen starting pet. I kind of like that hound model. It's like a bulldog. Because of that... I almost want to put Hounds at B, but they're going to C. Special abilities aren't that cool. But there's a lot of cool Hound-looking models. Okay, so Hydras. So Hydras have some cool models as well, like Chimeron in Blackwing Descent. Probably the coolest Hydra model. And then Hydra's ability is a Mortal Wounds, which is good. Why did I put Hounds at C again? Because I almost want to put Hydras at C. Oh, because their ability wasn't good. But there's cool models. So I have to put Hydras at B. Because their ability is good. Mortal Wounds is good. And there's a lot of cool Hydra models. They're also... Yeah, so they're a cunning pet with... No, sorry. Hydras are tenacity. Yeah, sorry. I don't know. I may have been misspeaking this entire video. The blue border is... the blue border is tenacity, the green border is cunning. Yeah, I got these pictures off of Petopia. Yeah, so with that being said, hounds are going up to B, Hydras you're going back down to C. So hyenas are a cunning pet, and their ability I think is a Mortal Wounds. Hyenas, there's not a whole lot of hyena models. Some of them look cool, like the ones all over Voldoon. They are a cunning pet with immortal wounds, which makes me want to put them at a B. Yeah. Hyenas, you're going to B. Basilisks. There are a lot of basilisk models, but none of them, in my opinion, are that cool. They're a cunning pet that reduces the movement speed of a target. So they are, I guess, good in PvP, but yeah. C. I have to go with C. That way, that is bad. Yeah, I've never really used Basilisk. I'm like 90. No, I'd say I'm like 80% sure that's a special ability, is a movement. Decrease target's movement speed. If it's not that, then it would have to be a defensive thing. And if it is a defensive thing, then they would be at a D tier, probably. No, I'm pretty sure it's a movement speed. Lizards. Lizards are. Theirs is a Mortal Wounds as well. There's some pretty cool lizard models, like snapdragons. Snapdragons all over Nashatar. I like that model. There's a lot of cool what are they called? Dimetrodons. Dimetrodons are lizards, right? Yeah, they are. I'm pretty sure. But they're a tenacity pet with immortal wounds. And their models aren't all that amazing. So they're going down to D. Mammoths. Mammoths are reduces movement speed of the target, which is a little odd. You'd think it would be like a defensive type of thing. But mammoths were added in Shadowlands. Well, they're taming mammoths, or at least. And there's some cool mammoth models. The only like cool mammoth model, in my opinion, is like an Iron Horde Elec. They're tenacity, mammoths are D tier. Mechanical pets. Now, mechanical pets, I almost want to put high because they're mechanical. They are cunning pets with a defensive cooldown. So it kind of counteracts each other. Like, mechanical pets, cunning is our pets you kind of want in PvP because of Master's Call, but Defense Matrix isn't really that good in PvP. But because there's a lot of cool mechanical pet models, I have to put them at a C. Mechabond Imprint Matrix, make sure you get that before you tame mechanical pets, unless you're a gnome or a goblin, because gnomes and goblins can inherently tame mechanical pets. If you're not, then you need a Mechabond Imprint Matrix, which is made by engineers. Okay, monkeys. So, monkeys, they're not that good. Yeah, they just aren't. Their special ability increases their dodge by 30%. But what I will say what monkeys have going for them is they have one of the best pet models in the game. I'll put a picture on the screen now. It is a monkey that is in the Swamp of Sorrows named Gib the Banana Hoarder, and it has a fez hat. So instead of putting them at D, just because of Gib, they're going to be a C. But usefulness, yeah, they're useless. Don't actually use monkeys in any, you know, scenario. Unless you want a cool looking pet with a fez hat. Moths. So moths have, they were a pet that I believe before, did moths do battle res? Or was it hero? Or was it dispel? I think before dispel they had a battle res. Or no, I think, no, Netherrace had a battle res. I don't know, who cares? That's in the past. We're talking about now. Serenity Dust is their special ability, which is a self-pet dispel. And, moths have a lot of interesting models. None that are too appealing to me. Moths are, yeah, moths are D tier. They just, yeah, moths are D tier. Oxens are tenacity, and they're good tanking pets because, first off, yeah, as I just said, they're tenacity. They, their special ability is called Niuzhao's Fortitude, I think. However you say his name, that dude, Niuzhao, which is the ability is when they fall below 40% health, they shrug off 60% damage. Yeah, I think I have to put them at B tier. Oxens are B tier. So, pterodaxes. Pterodaxes are pretty good, actually. They're kind of good. There's some interesting pterodax models, but their abilities are cunning. Their special ability is reduces, it's like when they fall below 40% health, their damage takes is reduced by 60%, you know, that sort of stuff. They are exotic. Pterodaxes do give you slow fall, which is why I like them. You know, if they were tenacity, I'd put them at B tier. But I have to put them at C tier. Just because, well, actually, a slow fall, a cunning slow fall pet, slow fall can be really useful in PvP. Not in arenas, but like, if you're like doing like a Wrathy Basin and you're up at Lumber Mill and you need to like jump all the way down to Blacksmith, use a Pterodax. They're going to C. Yeah. Okay, raptors. Raptors are God tier. So raptors, like, they're too good for their own good. So raptors are cunning pets with a mortal wounds. Except, you know, hyenas are also cunning pets with mortal wounds. But there's a lot more cooler raptor models than hyena models. Like, there's undead raptors. There's Raban, mummified raptor, at the end of King's Rest that you can tame. There's some, like, compies. You know, I gotta put raptors at A. I just have to. Because they got some cool models. Ravagers are ferocity. Ravagers have some cool models. Their special ability is a mortal wounds. Either C or D. Ravagers have to go D. Just because. Rays. Rays are, not that great. There are some cool ray models. Their special ability is the, I forget what it's called, but it's like a self-dispel. Dispels diseases, magics, and poisons, and whatever. Remember, the self-dispel is not on you, it's only on the pet. Rays used to be really good, because they used to give hero, I think. But now all ferocity pets give hero, so it's not a big deal. Rays are D tier. Bats are the exact same thing as rays. Pretty sure. Yeah, because bat special ability is the self-dispel thing as well. So with that being said, yep, They're going right there. River Beasts, their special ability is a Mortal Wounds. Tenacity Pet with a Mortal Wounds. Also, not a whole lot of cool looking River Beasts. There is one River Beast, its name is Wild Tusk in Zuldazar. I think its name is Wild Tusk, it's something like that. Where it's like has arrows sticking out of it, and when you tame it, it keeps those arrows. But, yeah, Tenacity Pet with a Mortal Wounds makes me put it at a D. Rodents. So Rodents' special ability is also Mortal Wounds. They're Cunning Pet with a Mortal Wounds. There's also some cool rodent models. So, do they go to C? No, I think they have to go to B. Actually, there's... Yeah. Yeah, rodents belong at B. Scale Heights. So their special ability is, I forget what it's called, but like reduces the damage they take by 50% for like 10 or 12 seconds or something like that. Scale Hides. There's some cool Scale Hides in Shadowlands. There's also like Thunder Lizards around Mulgore. Those are, you know, them. They're Ferocity Pet. But they're just a Ferocity Pet with a damage reduction type of deal. They belong at D. Scorpids. So Scorpid's special ability is a Mortal Wounds. There's a lot of cool Scorpid models. Like a lot of cool ones. Like Fiery Scorpids. All that type of stuff. Fiery Scorpids, Amber Scorpids, whatever. So they belong at C tier. Scorpids go up to C. Serpents. So Serpents are... think about Serpents. Their ability is useless. Increases their dodge by 30% type of thing. But Cloud Serpents are in that realm of Serpents. So they're cunning, but Cloud Serpents are cool. So I almost wanted to put them at B, but I can't put a pet at B just because it looks cool. So Serpents have to go C. Shale Beast is next. Yeah, Shale Beast. So there are some interesting Shale Beast models. They are exotic. So Shale Beast's special ability is reduces their damage taken by 50% for some amount of time. It's only like a 1 minute cooldown. And then their other ability reduces their magic damage taken, which is pretty interesting. Reduce their damage taken. I kind of want to put them at B just because of that. They're good tanking pets, except they're cunning. They're not, well, that's fine. I mean, it's fine to have a tanking pet that's cunning. Actually, it's not that fine. Okay. Spiders. So spiders reduce the target's movement speed. Of course, there are some cool spider models, but spiders don't really have a lot going for them. Besides that. So I think I have to put spiders at a D. D tier. Okay. Here we go. The moment we've all been waiting for. Spear Beasts. I mean, do I even need to explain? Do I really need to explain why Spear Beasts are S tier? Spear Beasts are one of the only three pets in the game that have an extra ability, as I mentioned before. The other two are Cats and Feathermanes. Cats and Feathermanes, as you can see, are non-exotic. So since Spear Beasts have an extra ability and they're exotic, they are the only pets in the game that have three special abilities. Three, not one, not two, but three, which makes them S tier. Now granted, Spear Beasts got massively nerfed in Shadowlands. But even with that, they're S tier. So Spear Beast's abilities are, first off, it's Spirit Walk. Yeah, so Spirit Walk is the good version of Prowl. Prowl does not increase the damage. I know, like, cats have Prowl. Prowl does not increase the damage of the cat's first ability when it leaves Prowl. That's what Spirit Walk does. It's still kind of annoying to use, but at least it's kind of like a buff sort of thing. They have Spirit Pulse, which is kind of useless-ish. So Spear Beasts used to have Trank Shot before they gave all hunters Trank Shot. Now they give Spirit Beast Spirit Pulse. So I'm not going to gripe on that too much because all hunters have Trank Shot. But Spirit Pulse is the like self-dispel disease magic effect type of thing. And then they have Spirit Mend. Now Spirit Mend was massively nerfed. Spirit Mend used to heal the hunter, for 50% of their health. 25% of it was instant, the other 25% was a hot. Now it's 15, now it's like 15%. So it's not that great, but it is a heal. Spirit beasts are pets that I use in, well, I used to use them all the time in a raid for the defensive cooldown because their tenacity and the heal, the extra heal. As long as my group didn't have a hero or bloodlust. If my pet needed a hero or bloodlust, I typically use a chimera or a devil sword. So spirit beasts I use in battlegrounds if I don't have like a pocket healer or in like soloing content. Spirit beasts are S tier. I mean, that's all there is to it. Like, sorry, not sorry. Spore bats. So spore bats are cunning. Their special ability is a self-dispel. Yeah, they're D tier. There's not a whole lot going on with them. So stags. Shadowlands introduced a lot of cool stag models in Ardenweald. Their special ability is the self-dispel thing as well. I think it's called Nature's Grace. And their tenacity. So, I have to put them at C tier just because there's a lot of cool models in like Ardenweald and things like that. Bears. So bears have some cool models as well. Like you can tame Amani bears, like Amani war bears that are in Zolomon. Like you can tame those. Those are bears. Bear special ability is their tenacity pet, where their special ability is like a damage reduction type of thing. Like when they fall below 40% health, damage they take is reduced by 60%. Because of that and tenacity, I have to put them at B tier. They're good tanking pets if you're survival. So oxens are that as well. I have to put bears at B tier. B for bear, you know. Stonehounds. So stonehounds are exotic. They're actually their exotic ability is interesting, and it's I guess kind of good. Yeah, I'd say Stonehound's exotic ability is good. So Stonehounds are when their health drops below 40% health, it's stone armor increases their reduces their damage taken by 60%. That's what stone armor is. Eternal Guardian is their exotic ability, which instant reses themselves. So it's on an 8-minute cooldown. Hunter pets used to have this back when like pet talent trees were a thing. You could have your pet spec into something called Phoenix's Heart or Heart of the Phoenix or something, which was an instant res for your pet on an 8-minute cooldown. Since pet talent trees aren't a thing anymore, they gave that ability to Stonehounds. So they definitely have to be B tier. In fact, they have to be A tier, because I put bears at B tier for having that one special ability plus being tenacity, but Stonehounds have that special ability plus tenacity plus Eternal Guardian. Plus there's some cool Stonehound models like Gargons and Revendreth. Those are all Stonehounds. And Quillens are definitely Stonehounds. Like the first boss in Magushan Palace or Magushan Vaults, or not Vaults, but you know, the raid where Elegon is the boss, the first boss in there, you can tame those. Tall Striders. So Tall Striders are Ferocity. Their special ability is movement speed thing. Yeah, there's not really a whole lot of Tall Strider models. Toads. So Toad's special ability increases their dodge. And Ardenweald has some cool Toad models, their tenacity. I guess I have to put them at C tier because like increasing their dodge plus being paired with tenacity is like complementary, you know? So there's that. Turtles. So Turtles' special ability is called Shell Shield. I used to use Turtles a lot actually, like way back when. It reduces their damage shaken by 50%. There's some cool turtle models as well. They are tenacity. So those two things are complementary. Definitely wouldn't be D tier. Why did I put Toads at C tier again? So Turtle special ability is better for tanking than Toads. I have to put Turtles at a B tier because of that. Warp Stalkers. Warp Stalkers, way back when, used to have the special ability of like teleporting to your target, which is really cool. They obviously don't have that now. Now their special ability is called like Warp or something, which reduces the target's movement speed. They're also cunning. Warp Stalkers kind of also look cool. Cunning plus reducing target movement speed is like complementary. They go to C. Warpsockers go to C. Wasps are, they got immortal wounds. There's some cool wasp models, but I wouldn't use a wasp pretty much ever. I think I have to put wasps at D. Yeah, yikes. Water striders. So water striders are pretty cool. They're cunning and they're exotic. So they get you Master's Call and all that good stuff. They have the self pet dispel, which I've kind of voiced my reasoning this video. I don't really care that much for that ability. But their exotic ability is Surface Trot, which is allows you to walk on water. Now you do have to cast it on yourself, and any damage does cancel it, but it's still a cool ability. So yeah, I think I have to put water striders at C. They don't deserve the B, to be honest. Wind serpents. So wind serpents are ferocity. They increase their own dodge by 30%. There's some really cool wind serpent models, like Bastion has a lot of wind serpents. Also, what's that one boss? Avatar Rakar in Sunken Temple. You can tame that. That's a wind serpent. So I think I have to put wind serpent C just because there's a lot of cool models of them, even though their abilities aren't all that, you know, special. Wolves. So wolves, there's a lot of wolf models in the game, I'm pretty sure. Especially Fenrir. Fenrir is a really cool model. It's one of my favorite models in the game, which almost makes me want to put wolves like closer to B tier. But wolves decrease the movement speed of the target, their ferocity. C. I mean, yeah, wolves are pretty C. Okay, worms. Let's get this over with. The worms are F tier. I know you might be thinking, what? They're exotic? How can they be F tier? So, wolves are tenacity pets that decrease the movement speed of the target by 50%. Now, their exotic ability is called Burrow Attack. They are one of the three pets in the game that have a special ability that has to do with damage. Chimeras being one. The second one is Corehounds. The third one is Worms. Burrow Attack is so counterproductive, it is not even funny. So what Burrow Attack does is when you have to manually use it, it's on a 14 second cooldown, your pet will burrow into the ground. It only casts this ability, it can't do anything else. When it's burrowed into the ground, it does a very small amount of damage. Beast Cleave is better than Burrow Attack, like 100 times better. You would never use Burrow Attack. It would in fact decrease your DPS to use, which is why they respectively get the F tier. But yeah, it's just a horrible ability. Not only that, but to my knowledge, when you cast Barb Shot, he can't get Frenzy. If he's burrowed in the ground, your worm cannot get Frenzy stacks, which is so bad on so many levels. It is using a worm as a decrease to your DPS. Worms do have some cool models, but that doesn't make up for the fact of how crap they are. So worms are F tier. Yeah, I said it. I'm not afraid of it. I'm not taking it back. Beetles. Okay, so beetles' special ability is their tenacity. Their abilities are complementary. Their tenacity and their special ability reduces their damage taken by 50%. So because of that, I mean, for the same reason about bears and turtles on B tier, beetles have to be B tier as well. Birds of prey. So birds of prey, their special ability is immortal wounds. I believe it's decreases the movement speed of the target. It's also cunning, which kind of is complementary, but there's a lot better cunning special abilities like having immortal wounds. There's also some cool birds of prey models. There's also lots of birds of prey models. They are C tier. Blood beasts. So blood beasts were introduced with Battle for Azeroth. Blood beasts are cool. They are pretty cool. So the only way to tame blood beasts is to get blood taming, which you get from killing Zul. That's his name, right? The third to last boss in Uldir. Zul, Prophet of Zul, Zul, whatever his name is. You just have to kill him on any difficulty that's not LFR, and it will drop a tome of taming blood beasts. Now their special ability is reduces the movement speed of the target by 50%. Before, when they were first introduced, I think they like siphoned the health from the target, which was cool. I have a blood beast at C, just because, I mean, their tenacity and their ability isn't complementary, but they look cool, so they deserve C. We're almost done here. Boars, their special ability is called Bristle, which reduces their damage taken. Their cunning, which isn't very complementary with each other. There's some interesting boar models. Like Maldraxxus has some cool boars, but I almost want to put them at a C tier, but they're going to D. Camels, last pet. So camels were introduced with, their taming of them at least was introduced with Shadowlands. There's some cool camel models like alpacas. Alpacas fall under that. They are, they got a good tanking ability when their health drops below 40%. I think it's called Hardy. When their health drops below 40%, their damage taken is decreased by 60%. So there's that, but they're also cunning. So it's like, there's also, the only camel models are just like normal camels you see in like Oldham and Tanneris. Well, does Tanneris have any camels anymore? I don't even remember. It's been so long since I've been there. Plus alpacas. I was about to put them at D tier. I think I'm gonna put them at C tier, just because alpacas are cool. And there you have it. There you have it. Though, that is my pet tier list. Wow, this was a long video. One of the longer videos I think I've posted. But there we go. Just to recap, the only good pets are spirit beasts and then anything that's on an A tier. Everything else is crap. Never use worms or else you're bad because they hurt your DPS. And yeah. If you guys like this video, feel free to leave a like on it. If you didn't like it, sorry, I don't blame you, but I will, but if you have any thoughts on if I made a god-awful mistake, put it in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video.